Last time, remember this picture in which we showed that the two segments here on the boundary of the square is a deformation retract, a strong deformation retract of the entire square I cross I. Just reflect this picture along the y-axis. What do you get? You will get minus 1 cross I here, minus 1, 2, plus 1 the interval here, and 1 cross I here as a subspace of minus 1 plus 1 cross I. And it will be a strong deformation retract. There is no need to write down another proof here, right? Now imagine you are inside this. This is x-axis and this is y-axis, and take another z-axis as horizontally in R3. Then along the y-axis, instead of reflecting, now you rotate the picture. What do you get? You will get this disk here of radius 1 cross I strongly deformation retracting to the tub, namely S1 cross I union the bottom disk. We follow this geometric argument. Once I have written down this one, I don't have to write formulas for them. It's obvious. So today we are going to make use of all these and do a lot of more generalizations of constructing deformation retracts. Okay, so that is the topic today, generalized construction. Think of the interval, closed interval 0 to 1 as a cone over 1. What is a cone over 1? What is a cone over anything? By definition, it is x cross I, and then x cross 0 being identified to a single point. So if x is singleton 1, what is x cross I? It is an interval. There is no further identification because endpoint is just in singleton 1 only. So think of this 1 as a cone over, sorry, interval as a cone over 1. Then the construction above can be generalized to any space X instead of the singleton one. Okay. So what you do is you use polar coordinates for the cone over X. Okay. So thus what you have is, let us look at this map, X cross I cross I cross I to X cross I cross I. See, in the earlier case, when X was singleton, we had this homotopy capital S from I cross I to I cross I, which is a strong deformation retract. So that didn't write any singleton X here. But now you want to write the whole space X, so you have to write X cross that. Okay. So the X factor is a dummy. What we are interested in is the homotopy is capital S, which was defined last time from I cross I to I cross I. Okay. So therefore, let us define H as H of X, comma T, T prime, T double prime is X as it is. Take S of the other three variables. S of T, T prime, T double prime. which is obtained by, you know, pushing stereographic projection from 0, 2. Projection from 0, 2. So this was the map. Okay. So what will be the image, namely when T double prime is equal to 1. All these you have to see. Let us use the notation x comma t bracket round bracket x comma a comma b round bracket etc. to denote the image of xt xab etc. inside the product space under the quotient maps, where quotient maps are cone construction. There is one cone construction q from x cross I to cx. Okay. Then if I take one more cross I, it will be cx cross I, cross I, cx cross I, cross I, and so on. Let me have one uniform notation instead of too many notations. Whenever I write round brackets, they are in the product space. Whenever I write square brackets, they are corresponding cx cross I. Okay. Starting with a map from x cross I cross I cross I, the last two factors are not affected at all, but x cross I, this factor, there will be a quotient map to the cx, wherein x cross 0 has been identified to a single point. The point of this one is when the first coordinate here, this t, is 0, then this entire map S of 0, t, t prime, t double prime is a single point. So therefore, you know, this makes sense, and it will go factor down from the quotient space to the quotient space here, cx cross I. This is the quotient space here, cx cross I. Okay, so that is the whole idea here. Okay. So under the quotient map, q cross identity, etc., the function h respects equivalence relations defined by the cone, because the t coordinate of s 0 t prime t double prime is always 0. So it will be something, it may be x, actually x comma something, cross something, something, but that whole thing x can be collapsed to a single point. Okay, the t coordinate of this part is always 0. So here the t coordinate going to 0, so it is just fine. Hence there is a well-defined map, quotient map, I mean the induced map, co-induced map, h bar, from cx cross I to cx cross I. Okay, what is the formula? H bar of this equivalence class xt t prime t double prime is the first coordinate is x, and s of t t double prime t prime t double prime. Okay, so if you just write like this, you need to verify why this is well defined. Because when t is 0, there will be different x's here. Okay. But when t is 0, look at the x comma some number, right? But that is also 0. Therefore, this is a well-defined function in cx cross I. So this is two coordinates here, right? S of t, t prime, t double prime may look like some alpha comma beta, where alpha beta are elements of I cross I. When t is 0, alpha will be always 0. Therefore, this is a very different function, is what I wanted to say. Instead of writing S of this one in two different formula and so on, I'm just writing this way. So you have to just check this S is the function that we have got last time. Okay. So let's have a look at this one. So you see, when t is 0, what happens to the first coordinate here? That is why I have written down this formula in terms of t t prime t double prime. if I write like this, it's not clear what happens. Okay. T is 0. This is the formula which is valid. This will not come at all. Never T prime is bigger than or equal to 2T. 2. And then T is 0. So it is this one. So T prime is less than 2 is always possible. So look at this formula. T is 0, this part is 0. Right? T here, there is a T here, this part is also 0. The first coordinate here is 0. This will 1 minus t double prime t prime is independent of t anyway, doesn't matter. This part is 0 is all that I need. Okay, so we have a map like this. Now you can verify that it is actually identity, all those things, identity when, you know, this last quantity double prime is 1. At is 0, and then at t equal to 1, it takes values inside, blah, blah, blah. So what is the image? All that you can verify. Exactly same way as in for just for S prime. The X part has no role to play here. Okay? So it can directly verify that it's a continuous map also, but you don't need to do that because of the quotient space theory. The continuity at points of this one, you can get it because we have a formula there. Okay. Alternatively, you can use theorem 3.4, which is just the quotient of product. Product by the, that's true. Product of the quotient, the second factors are identity. Okay. Why it is a quotient map? Because I is compact. So in particular, it's locally compact. We have proved that. For locally compact space, X to Y is a quotient map. If Z is locally compact, then X cross Z to Y cross Z, Q cross identity is also a quotient map. If you use that theorem, then continuity of H bar is obvious. You don't have to verify. If you don't know that theorem, you can directly verify this by looking at the formula. At each part, you just say it is given by a certain formula. Projection maps, X comma something, that something is continuous. So that's what it is. To show that CX cross I is a quotient topology, you can use this theorem and then you are done. Okay. So the conclusion is that for any topological space X, CX cross 0 union X cross I is a strong differential tract of CX cross I, where we identify X with the image of CX, with the image in CX of the space X cross 1. Okay, X is identified in that. If you put X equal to 1 for single point, for CX is just CX cross 0 will be just I. Okay, I cross 0. Union 0 cross I, sorry, 0, not X, 1 cross I at the other end, right? This is the starting point, the bottom line and the one sidebar along the parallel to Y axis is a strong differential tract of I cross I. That was the starting point. But instead of that I, now I am replacing by CX. Okay, I. Two such examples I gave. One is by reflecting it, I get it for the whole, cone over S naught. The interval can be thought of as cone over S naught. Cone over S1 is got by rotating the whole picture along the y-axis. Why bother? That is all geometrically you can do, but you can do this by just simple argument. Just CX, wherever it is. It is a cone over X. Okay? So the bottom CX cross 0 and CX cross I and X cross 1, X cross I itself, okay? That is a subspace of CX cross I. Right? is a strong diffusionary tract of CS crossi. So this figure I have already told you. Now I am drawing those two figures. This is the reflection here of the earlier picture, and this is got by rotating. So what you got here is now, it's a bathtub. The solid thing, okay, if a whole, this is like an ice, the ice melts out, but only the only the container is left out. There will be a number of applications now, one by one. Let A be any closed subspace of S. Okay. Then the pair XA has homotopy extension property with respect to every space. If and only if the subspace A cross I union X cross 0 is a rectract of X cross I. What is the meaning of it as homotopy extension property with respect to every space? That is, the inclusion map is a cofibration. Okay, so this is what inclusion map is a cofibration if and only if A cross I union X cross 0 is a rectract of X cross I. So this is the direct application to homotopy theory of that simple construction of STR that we have done. Okay. This is a picture. The bottom thing is X. X cross I is this picture. A is the triangle, is a subspace there. A cross I is standing here. You have to take A cross I, union the bottom. X, X cross 0. This is a strong deformation retract of the entire X cross I. The hypothesis is that A to X, the inclusion, must be a cofibration. The stronger conclusion is that this is if and only if. So that is a fantastic conclusion. Why? Because to verify something is a cofibration, you have to verify for every space, every map, blah, 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 right? Homotopy extension property you have to establish. It's an impossible task. Here, you have to only verify that this particular subspace, whether it is strong deformation retract of X cross I or not. Over. So, this is going to be extremely useful theorem. Okay. Small, small results. Okay. But they are going to build up the whole theory, what is called a homotopy theory, right? So let us work out how this is done. To prove the if part, that means suppose you have the deformation retract, then I want to show that this is A to X is a cofibration. Cofibration means what? So let us assume that there is a retraction R from X cross I to Z. This is just a retract, sorry. It's not even a strong definite retract or anything. Suppose you have just a retract. Retract means what? Restricted to Z, it's identity. It's a continuous function from the whole space to subspace. What is Z? Z is, I have introduced this notation, namely, A cross I union X cross 0. Okay, suppose there is a retraction. All right, now suppose there is a homotopy extension data as in definition 1.4. What does this mean? This means that you have a map from A cross I to some y, and on X cross 0, A is inclusion map, the restriction map can be extended. Then I want to have an extension on the entire of x cross I, of the homotopy H. So suppose you have such a homotopy data, okay? So I have treated it as a map theta, which is the union of these two things, namely theta restricted to A cross I is the homotopy F, theta restricted to X cross 0 is the map G, which is the extension of F on A cross 0. Okay, define theta from Z to Y by taking this restriction, namely restriction A cross I is F and on X cross 0 is G. Okay, so what you have is a map from Z to Y. Then there is a map from X cross I to Z, which is R. Take the composite, that G be theta composite R. Okay, all that I want to say is G is the required homotopy extension. Okay, because R is identity on this part, when you take R composite theta, it will be, when you restrict it to X cross 0, it will be the required map, X cross I and A cross I, that's all. And it is an extension, it is defined on the whole of R, X cross I. Okay, so this comes as if by magic. All right. Now, this retraction we want to construct if the inclusion map is a cofibration, that is the converse. Suppose XA has homotopy extension property with respect to every space Y. In this case, now I take Y to be Z itself, okay? And F and G be the corresponding inclusion maps. What is F? A cross I to Z, it's inclusion. What is G? G is X cross 0 inclusion. All right, so that is the data. So with this data, there will be capital G from X cross I to Z, which is a continuous function, which extends this one. That just means that on Z, it must be identity. So it's a retraction over. Okay. Go back to the statement. Statement says that starting with A, any closed subspace of X, then being a cofibration or Z being a retract, these two are equivalent. Inclusion map cofibration or this A cross I union X cross 0 retract, these two are equivalent. Where did we use that A is a closed subspace? Why do we have that hypothesis? Look at this one. I defined this theta by patching both two different functions. On this set itself, that's continuous. On theta restricted to X cross 0, it is G, it is continuous. These are hypotheses. But why theta is continuous? On the intersection, namely A cross 0, this capital F agrees with G. G restricted to A cross 0, because G is an extension of that A cross 0, map on A cross 0, F. Okay, as a function, it is well defined. But why it is continuous? You need some hypothesis, namely, if A is closed, then the intersection, namely A cross 0 here, of these two will be a closed subspace. Okay, look at A cross I and X cross 0. What is the intersection? It's A cross 0. That must be a closed subspace. The same thing as A must be a closed subspace. So the hypothesis is required there to say that theta is continuous, first of all. Okay. It is not a very costly hypothesis, because finally what you get is the converse, namely A to X is a co-fibration, then what has happened? A cross this one, Z is a closed subspace of the whole thing if X is Hausdorff. Any retract of a Hausdorff space is closed. That's what we know. If Z is closed, then A cross 0 will be closed subspace, which is very easy because you have just intersected with X cross 0. Z intersection X cross 0, okay, or X cross T, or X cross 1 actually, is A cross 1. So A cross 1 is closed, the same thing as A is closed in X. So under Hausdorffness, the closeness of A is a must. So we are not assuming too much. All right. So I have told you already that this proposition comes extremely handy in determining whether the inclusion map is co-fibration or not. Okay, it reduces the practically impossible task of verifying the homotopy extension property with respect to every space to just one task of checking whether the subspace X cross 0 union A cross I is retract or not. Okay, so this itself has many bits applications. Okay, so let us take a look at some of these applications now. If the inclusion map is a co-fibration, then for any space Z, the inclusion map Z cross A to Z cross X is also a co-fibration. So Z cross A to Z cross X, what is the map? It is the inclusion map again, because A to X is an inclusion map. How do you do that? Of course, here all I have, for all array, I have assumed that A is a closed subspace. Huh? Because that is, to apply that theorem, you need a closed subspace. Okay. So why is it a co-fibration? I have to just verify that Z cross A cross I union Z cross A cross 0, sorry, Z cross X cross 0 is a deformation is a retract of X cross Z cross X cross I from the hypothesis that for X cross I the corresponding things are true. So everywhere you just take Z cross with Z. Okay, so this is very straightforward. So this is what I have done. With a retraction X cross I to X cross 0 union A cross I, okay, right, R of Z comma X comma T, keep Z as it is, look at just second factor is R of X T. Just taking identity cross R, identity of Z cross R, that will give you the corresponding thing for the product. Next corollary is also as easy. Take any topological space, the inclusion map X inside X cross 1, okay, of X into CX. Remember, in the cone, X was identified with X cross 1 as a subspace. So now I'm thinking of X as a subspace of the cone. That inclusion map is always a co-fibration. At least here, you don't have to assume something closed. Automatically, X is a closed subspace of the cone. Okay. So now the X itself is a co-fibration. Inclusion map is a co-fibration. Okay, can you see this, how to get this corollary? Just like in this case, okay, you have got a product now, right? Now you can take the cone over that one also. In the previous thing, you got a product. You can parameterize, once you have this R, can parameterize by any other another factor. Okay. So I will leave it to you to think about these things. This may be, unless you write down something, you may have difficulty. So Cx, the cone over x, contains the bottom space x, x cross 1, as an inclusion map will be a cofibration, is the statement. In particular, we have seen that one is the bottom of the cone over 1 in the interval 0, 1, right? The singleton 1 inclusion into the interval is a cofibration. You can directly prove it also. Okay, but actually the first picture itself proves that at the starting point. But now I have something more here, corollary. Take any point in between also. This also a cofibration. I told you how to make it reflect it and then the center, making the center and so on. So this is the trick. So you reflect it on the other side. So one is a was a retract. Now you retract it on the other side. So instead of end two endpoints, you'll get a central one, an edge here. Okay, the above construction can be used to get a picture for this one also. Method of construction can be used to prove that any map, inclusion map, is a cofibration. Go back to that theorem, that proposition, and try to prove that retract is possible. That's all. Once you have this, take any space Z and any point T in I. The inclusion map Z cross T in Z cross I is a cofibration. This is a direct consequence of two of the previous theorem. First, you can use this one, and then you can use this product theorem. So combine these two corollaries, you get this corollary. For any point, Z cross T inclusion into Z cross I is a cofibration. Okay. Let us stop here and take up more further applications in the next module. Thank you.